This is the third film in your post 9/11 trilogy, and I think it differs from the other two in several significant ways. I think the most obvious one being that you are a participant in the story, you are not present in the other two films. Can you talk about the thought process and how you arrived at?
Yeah, sure. I mean, not unlike Snowden, I actually didn't want to be in this film, as my editor, as Mathilde, would testify to, that I had to be, no. But it was clear that I had to be, that I had to be present in the film, because the audience had a right to know that I was a participant in the events. But the question of how to be sort of subjective, it's a complicated one for these three films. When I made the film in Iraq, I was filming with Iraqi civilians, and it was a very dangerous time to be working in Iraq. But I didn't want the focus be on the Western journalist, in a dangerous conflict zone, because then sort of all the empathetic energy could sort of move towards me rather than the people that I actually wanted to be the focus of the story. So in Iraq, I absolutely didn't want to draw any attention to the circumstances of how I was working or any risks that I might face, because it was about having people understand what the occupation is like from the perspective of Iraqis and the U.S. military. So I'm very invisible in that film. I mean, I always think that, obviously there's a camera there, so I'm sort of part of it. I've been invited, so I'm present. With The Oath, it was actually a complicated one. I approached it in the same way, which is sort of a verite, where I'm sort of, watching scenes unfold. But Jonathan Oppenheim, who edited it, at some point we were doing test screenings before we finished, and he was aware there was an uneasiness amongst the audience that we didn't acknowledge the presence of the camera, because the access was sort of so unusual and sort of like, how is there a camera here? So we realized that we were taking the viewer outside of the story by not acknowledging the presence, my presence. So he then changed and put my voice in a few things. And this one, it begins with, I think this film begins with I, I was placed on a watch list, et cetera. And so it's certainly the first film that I've done from a first person.